Example 6, the following table shows the weight distribution of 200 sacks of papayas in kilogram. Okay, given that the weight in kg, okay, and then the frequency, you need to construct a relative frequency distribution table, a histogram, and a frequency polygon. Okay, to construct a relative frequency distribution table, okay, you need to add on another extra column here for relative frequency. Okay, the formula to calculate the relative frequency equal to frequency of each class divided by number of observation. Okay, for example, here. Okay, relative frequency equal to frequency of each class, frequency of the first class 2 divided by number of observation. So the number of observation here, total here, equal to 200. Okay, so divide by 200, so you will get 0.01, and 12 divide by 200 equal to 0.06, and so on. Okay, next, part B, draw histogram. So the title, weight distribution of 200 sacks of papayas, and then the y-axis for frequency and the x-axis for weight in kg. Make sure this one the lower boundary for the first class, and this is the upper boundary for the first class, then followed by second interval, third, and so on. Okay, part C, how to construct a frequency polygon. So the first thing we are going to do is to draw a x and y axis. Now we need to label both these axes. The y axis going to be the frequency for each class. Okay, the largest frequency is 52. So you can label up until 60. You can choose 1 cm or 2 cm for 10 sacks of papaya. So we are gonna mark 0, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, and 60. So before we label the x-axis here, we need to calculate the class midpoint for each of the classes first. So I hope that you still remember how to calculate the class midpoint. Okay, for example here, at the table here. So the midpoint for the first class equal to, the formula to finding a midpoint is the lower boundary plus upper boundary divided by 2. So this one is the formula to calculate the midpoint. For example, the first class here, the lower boundary equal to 39.95 plus upper boundary for the first class 44.95 divided by 2 equal to 42.45. Okay, this one. And calculate until you get 77.45. So you plot the points for the first class. The first midpoint is 42.45, and the frequency equal to 2. So you plot here, and then followed by when the midpoint equal to 47.45. The frequency equal to 12, so somewhere here, and then this one, and then by using ruler, connect the dots from class 1 to class 2 to class 3 until last class. And one last thing, at the x-axis here, okay, we need to draw a line at the beginning and at the end of the graph when your frequency equal to zero. So you need to find the midpoint before the first class, so 37.45. Okay, make sure the distance, the unit is the same. And the last part here at the end of the graph, the midpoint after the last class, so 82.45. So connect line before and after so that your graph does not hang in. Example 7, a random sample of 300 rods produced by a small factory was chosen. The lengths measured to the nearest millimeter were recorded as follows. So given that the length and frequency, and you need to construct a cumulative frequency table and draw an ogive. Okay, to construct a cumulative frequency table, you need to add on another one column here and label it as cumulative frequency. So how to calculate cumulative frequency? Adding the frequencies of all the classes below and until upper class boundary. Alright, so start now. So 0 plus 5 equal to 5. And then 5 here plus with 12 here. So you get 17. And then 17 here plus with 26, you get 43. 43 plus 38, 81. 81 plus 78, 159. 159 plus 68, 227. And until 297 plus 3, you get 300 for the last cumulative frequency. So the last cumulative frequency for the last class here, 300, must be equal to the total of frequency here. So total frequency here is 300, so must be tally with the last cumulative frequency, 300. How to construct an ogive? So you need to stand by your own graph paper, and the first thing we are going to draw is a x and y axis. Now we need to label both these axes. The y axis going to be the cumulative frequency for each class. The largest cumulative frequency is 300. So you can choose 1 cm or 2 cm for 50 rods. We are gonna mark 0, 50, 100, 150, 200, 250, 300, and 350. So before we label the x-axis, we need to calculate the upper boundary for each of the classes. So the upper boundary, okay, calculate until you get at 74.5 here. Alright, so to plot the graph, the ogive, so the first upper boundary for the first class is at 29.5, and the cumulative frequency is 5, so somewhere here, and then followed by at 34.5, and the cumulative frequency is 17, so somewhere here, up until at 74.5, and the cumulative frequency 300. And then you connect all the line. Last thing, don't forget the upper boundary before the first class at 4.5 when the cumulative frequency equal to zero, so that your ogive does not hang in.